It's a hell of an achievement. I think it's something that will stay with people for the rest of their life.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear the
sorrow,
to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far.
I've got to tell you right now, I feel 10 foot tall and bulletproof. It's sensational.
Okay, magnificent start to the trip. We have no bloody bags from Johannesburg.
And also, you guys must stop giving Brad a hard time, man. He's going to have a coronary, eh?
Hi,
so to orientate the map that way, when we walk, we're going to be going in this northerly direction. It's a pretty desolate countryside. Lodges over here, and we'll be doing our game drives in that area. Okay, make yourself at home.
Have you been doing your 24?
Water.
Gents, when you have a shower, if we
go down the stairs of the main area, there's a small little thatched hut.
Yeah, but there
will always be some. Run,
sure you be
best shot.
That's okay.
You got a tracker then?
Yeah.
The one that created pandemonium.
Teeth here for gripping their prey.
Your latches on.
Look at these little feet over here. This animal has probably evolved from a lizard.
Look at that, is just incredible.
Are we sleeping under the stars?
The Okavango itself is defined in a number of distinct formations. You've got the panhandle up in the north here.
This river used to flow through there, and this whole lot just collapsed into the ground. And also said you don't get anxious with us on safety. The weapon is open. I still haven't loaded up.
And if you think that your partner is suffering a little bit, tell one of us.
Promethazine, Phenagan, allergic reaction.
Endura. Magnesium rehydration.
We will never have a round in here. The trigger will also be released.
I think he's an idiot. Can I tell you that too?
Any last words, mate?
What a great scene. The sun coming up, caravan at the ready, a whole lot of big fit guys hanging around, shitting themselves.
Hi, have fun.
Goodbye, crew world.
Okay, guys, basically, we're flying out of a swamp.
This is it. We're going in. No going back now.
Tourette's is not in remission yet.
This is called the first morning rondvrtel.
Expectations?
Huge.
Have fun. Be alert. And just remember what we did yesterday. I think relax. It's very important to relax. It's going to be very easy. Enjoy yourselves.
45. Oh, that's about 48 seconds, mate. That's a hell of a performance.
We've got our first elephant.
Now this is the danger of elephants. You see the wind? It's changed directions, north, northeast. They can't smell us. They can hardly hear us. That's how easy you can walk into them. We'll speed up as things warm up. Obviously, this is also one of the thickest parts of the trip.
Actually, that thing that Ant's got in his hand is actually just an iPod. He's got no idea where we are. Bloody South Africans.
The only way to cut out the Aussie crap.
Well, this is easy. This is a game trail, basically, that we're walking on. The hippos, ellies, buffalo, zebra all use this path over probably thousands of years. So this is the easy part. Maybe it's the calm before the storm.
Okay guys, this is our first piece of ivory. We're in the area where possibly the densest elephant populations occur in Africa. Also the fact that some governments want to cull elephants because there's too many. Often is an excuse to gain a quick source of revenue.
This beautiful grove of trees.
That's the giant eagle owl. It's one of the largest owls in the world. We've arrived here. We're going to be going northeast up onto these red points. We don't want to be walking here, and with the wind blowing, elephants are going to smell us and chase us into this crap. Yeah, but this would have been what they would have made tortoise shell sunglasses out of, eh? You can see still some remnants of the tortoise over there.
A little bit smell of the tongue. Nice.
It's actually a bit older, huh?
We're just gonna wait and see what this bull does.
So he's just chilling out there like any old gentleman. He's got no hassles with anything. But you get into a situation, we get the females with the young ones, those are the ones we're avoiding. They, as we said, they can get full of rage.
Is it 20 or 30 steps.
Muscular, mate, or sharp?
No, sharp, mate.
Really?
Yeah.
Simon. Sharp. Now, very important here, Simon, the bullet shape goes in. You pull this off, open your knot, you slide in, you put it up, and it'll go, whoop, and it'll suck in, eh?
Do you need any Vaseline?
My anus.
Your anus.
My arnus.
Your anus dominus.
Hey,
John,
mate.
Take my cap with. Oh, my Edward. A bit of a sore ankle.
Okay. Hey, Simon. Good luck, mate. Can't get him, big fella.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you.
Good luck, mate.
Limping now and walking like a cowboy as well.
Yeah. If you saw what I did with my hands, you wouldn't be doing that. You're really a part of me.
I've got you under my skin. I try. Okay, that is Paul's second piss in about 5 minutes.
From a firm nest frog, so the female will pass the eggs out, the male will clasp her from behind, and as the eggs come out, he'll inseminate them externally, which we call spawning, like fish. It will often hang over a pond. It's the first time I've seen on a piece of elephant crap. Obviously there's a serious demand for this water, and as he's mating, and while they're mating, she'll whip up this foam, and the tadpoles will live in here and grow and grow and grow with this mucus mass. And then once they get big, they'll fall into the water.
There we go. 329 meters to pan 10. We have got about, according to Ant, who knows very little about this caper,
We've got about 3 Ks probably to go to camp. First day, a little bit of weather coming.
We're almost there, huh? Yeah.
Well done, gents.
Couple of tight situations.
Yeah, great. Thanks. Thank you. 1 to 3, that's good.
Look at this, here we go.
Simon, how are you? I'm Daniel. Nice
Daniel,
to
Simon,
you.
Lovely to meet you. Sam, hey, Rose,
how are you
mate?
Doing, man?
Good to see you.
Great.
At the other end. Simon.
Sam, what? I'm Joe.
Joe,
nice to meet you.
Europectes mozambicense.
So even though the day's walk was pretty long, pretty tough, we're not exactly roughing it at night. Look at this little setting with a beautiful braai happening. That's a barbecue.
For dessert, we have roasted marshmallows.
Just be very cautious of the sun. It looks like we're gonna have a blue sky. Okay.
A few little aches and pains, but there's still 7 of us. Plus Tony and Ant, of course. We'd be stuffed without them.
There's some baboons up ahead.
Minerals in the pond there.
You don't see too many of these guys.
It's a baby chica. It's very small.
It is the song of the cicadas. That is extraordinarily loud. Amazing.
Moving, just keep moving. Till I don't know what to say.
It is extremely warm now. Temperature's probably more like in the mid 30s. We got big weather systems building up all around us here. Very dramatic. Nearing the middle of the day. Very dramatic. And very bloody hot.
On fire, mate.
On fire.
On fire. Yeah. I'm surprised we're not running.
Having a blast.
Don't mind saying that I am feeling the heat right here.
Time to excise the toe.
Full scale operation.
Okay, put your heel, flex your heel. That doesn't work. We just.
We managed to miss out yesterday, but it looks like we're going to get a little bit wet today, but we've come pretty prepared for that. Everyone's got wet weather packs and raincoats.
All the animals that during the winter months would have been concentrated on the rivers have now dispersed into these woodlands. They're going to start over the next 2-3 weeks to actually move into these woodlands and move away from the Cylinder River, the Okavango, the Lunyanti, etc.
We have survived day 2. The camp.
Yeehaw!
Not quite there. A little bit of a water crossing first. Oh, look at the saddle bill. Great temperature too.
Thank you.
termites.
These are the things, believe it or not, that the Okavango Delta is built on. Termites, literally billions of them. With the first rains, these things come out and everything feeds on them. It is just incredible. This is a red-lipped herald snake. He's not dangerous. And he's feeding on a guttural toad.
Wow.
That's the third snake species we've seen, huh?
Morning of day three. We are underway about possibly 25 kilometers ahead today, but the longest walk of the trip so far. And why didn't you build a road for us the whole way through here? It's been a lot easier.
You Aussies are tough.
Tony's just walking about probably 70, 80 metres ahead of us, just in case there's anything to surprise us coming out of the woodland.
There's 9,695 steps in just under 2 hours, so that's motoring along nicely. Good.
Yeah, is that the only one you need done?
I think so.
Yeah, they went off your phone for a while.
Yeah, it'll be right. It's feeling all right.
Yeah, yeah.
How are they this morning?
Oh, a bit testy, but I'll give
it. HGFQ.
Some lovely biltong.
If not, Paul.
The food of Africa.
Go and give us an explanation, Amps.
No, come on, Tim. What is this?
This is a monkey.
What sort of monkey?
A dead one.
That's very good. This is one of Tim's relations from Townsville.
What's that, mate?
No, it's all right, Oz.
Final stretch, day three. Hot walk, but we made very good time up the spillway. Cold beer, not far away.
Hi guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Good to see you again. We missed you. Get to the
Great stuff.
28,995.
28,995 steps.
So that's 3 days down, three to go. So we've done about 90,000 steps so far.
Didn't even get the diesel. Eventually they're egging each other on and they're getting more and more into it.
Okay, Moosey, you're going to have a smelly ride with that biltong once I open it.
Paul, like Brad, has polished his boot this morning.
Right, so maybe more zebras coming down. But typical at this time of the year, the zebras start migrating into the area, following up on this fresh green flush that's come out. Just taste it. A bit of taste for the edge, eh?
Throw it away and just put your finger in there.
Tastes like chicken.
Just watch, they've got very good visual. Okay, very good eyes and well spotted, mate. We're gonna try and sneak up on the top here. The reputation of these animals, this one, hunters used to hunt them for trophies, big time in the old days, and they weren't trained or they weren't aware of how to do it, delivering non-fatal shots in the heart lung area and then tracking these animals on foot, the blood trail, and what the buffalo do, they'll wait over here for you. And as you come past, he'll hammer you. And they deserve the reputation, Africa's Black Death.
Well, I might not be speaking for everyone in the group here, but this last little bit, this is a pretty tough country. Hot, visibility is not much good with the Mapani. Feeling the pinch a little bit. Everyone's morale's still up, which is good. Just get that sort of rhythm going in the walk. Head down, following the guy's feet in front of you.
I'm just telling the camera it's hot.
Well, we've been coming through this back country for about 12 or 14 kilometres now. All hot and bothered. Mid-30s today. And now we're back at the spillway. I'm pretty happy to see some open country. Yay!
That was hard work, eh?
How are you feeling, mate?
Tired, mate. Must have done about 80 k's now. Not looking forward to an ending.
I've had it. See, you can get it pulling the plough, feeding the cow. Matter of fact.
Oh, God. He's got it now. Brad.
How's it going, mate?
Good, mate.
Enjoying?
Very much.
Good.
Very much.
Ask me when I've got a beer in my hand and I'll probably give you a different answer, I think.
Tim, battle scarred.
Tim, oh, he's not a lawyer, sorry.
But ploughing on.
Yes.
And not saying much.
No.
He's as stuffed as the rest of us.
Right up, Brad.
There he is.
Every night, buddy. That's what we call him, Danny
Fitzgerald. Paul, you're a legend.
Watch your ankles, perfection.
Watch your ankles, guys. Hi, guys.
That was a very big day, which kind of adds to the elation when you reach the other end.
So, well done, mate. Yeah, great stuff. Good stuff. Well done, Tyne. Thank you very much. Great day.
Hey, packs off.
And thanks a lot, mate.
You're welcome.
Tough day, mate. Good job.
Just over the 33,000, 33,006. That's about 15% more steps than yesterday. It's felt like someone's been nailing me with hot pokers today on the bottom of the feet. Looking forward to that cold beer.
This afternoon's activity is sponsored by Hansa, the beer of Botswana.
The kiss of the SARS hop.
Bracingly crisp.
Whatever that means.
Whatever that means.
Cheers, man.
What I'd like to say is between here and that bend, let's try not to talk, let's keep quiet, just in case there are around, okay?
I'd just like to draw attention to the wonderful new addition to Paul, which is the rock Hudson nice. Cravat. No clean boots overnight, but gee, the strides look good. Strides look great. Yep. Up. Shirt, cravat. Oh, fantastic.
I'll shave tomorrow.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Obviously, age, Steve, roughly, I'd say 52.
From this stride, I could say he's walking confidently through the bush right up to the moment. Hang on, there's two knee marks ahead. Looks like he's gone down.
We've had a major accident here. Greg's gone down. Bad fall.
Sign of fatigue.
Yep.
About 300 legs. There was a centipede has less legs than the centipede is toxic.
Oh.
Or poisonous. Venomous, huh? Centipede will bite you.
Very therapeutic, isn't it? Just like a...
Don't say. Okay, it's a spotted bush snake, huh? But this is where Africa is very different to Australia. At some stage in the evolution of the Earth, and also the splitting up of the continents, Australia went one way, and that was marsupials and a whole host of other strange animals. The snakes in Africa are mainly part of the family called the colubrids, or the backfanged. That's the boomslang, the tree snakes, the grass snakes, the bush snakes. Whereas in Australia, they're part of the family or the group called the elapids, which are the cobra family. Your brown snakes, your taipans, all that mob. Our mambas and our cobras are a rudimentary group of what you have, and that's why in Australia you have so many venomous snakes. Your cobras, or your cobra-type snakes, when they bite you, they affect your nervous system, and you have a slow shutdown. It would be the equivalent, we've worked out, on an empty stomach, an 80-kilogram man, having 2 to 3 neat bottles of vodka. That's the effect of some of your snakes. It's a sudden shutdown in your system. your lungs.
Okay. Okay, now put your hand down. Slowly lower your hand.
Slowly.
No, your right hand.
Yeah.
Down, down, until the length of his body. Right down.
Yeah.
Take your left finger out. Okay.
And just point him on his way.
Let go. Let go.
Can I put him back up to
him? No, no. You got it. That's it. We're going to go behind the tree here. If these buffalo come towards us, you stand your ground, eh? Okay. That's what we need to be concerned about. See how quiet we're walking? They think we're elephants or whatever. And also these very few humans that move through this area, so they're not suspicious. But the minute they picked up, we're humans.
We've had two buffalo encounters today. Good for a little bit of adrenaline. Both very safe encounters though, where we kept a good distance from the animals and didn't surprise them. And now we're right into this back country once again. This Mopani.
They've got eyes like your local lady gossips. It's very hard to dodge a giraffe. Ahead of us, okay? So we're just gonna sneak up. They've probably seen us. Let's have a look. This way. You can talk to me, but whisper. Whispering stops just over here. Don't use the deep part of your voice, okay? Let's take our time. We're gonna walk with this bull. We're gonna have some. See what he gets up to, okay? You're perfectly safe, okay? The wind is blowing from my back across this way. Let's carry on, okay? That's where the elephant's tail is on Greg's wrist.
Trying to get close to this breeding. See how we go.
Not only have us taken a breaker for the shade and to look at the zebras, but we've got a traffic jam here. We can't continue. This is our route to Zibilianja.
Of Africa, you know, whether you're in a vehicle, whether you're on foot, whatever, to watch animals in their own environment, just doing their thing,
stunning.
And knowing that you haven't interrupted his afternoon's feeding, you could hear the grumbles from his stomach, everything. Watch him throw him a bit of mud on himself. Absolutely priceless.
Cheers. Lovely. Depending what he does, okay? Okay, so if it comes this side, we go this side, eh? This side. Okay, which side is she? Hey! Go away! That's why we didn't come through initially. Is everyone okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm glad we did some rehearsals at Tuba. Okay guys, we've eventually arrived at the Lanyanti. You see these beautiful savannas. You can see the palm trees in the distance. And right beyond that, the green papyrus. Our camp is not far from here, but you can see a total change in vegetation again. Hold it, huh?
smell.
Okay, guys. He's a massive predator, huh? The claws. Look at these massive claws. Almost like a raptor. It looks just like a bird of prey. There's not much difference between a bird of prey and a lizard. Now, this is a Nile monitor. We also get the rock monitor. Look at this lovely beaded skin. This guy's a very good tree climber, but this particular one prefers to swim. Now, if you look at the tail, look at the tail over here. The tail is flat like a crocodile. And this is one of his best weapons. The tail is serrated on the top. And if you catch him incorrectly, or if a lion, you don't know what you're doing, he'll fling this at you and he can inflict a severe cut. I'm not gonna force it, but when the tongue comes out like a snake. And that is typical of the monitors of the varanus lizards, is that it has a tongue like a snake, huh? Mm-hmm. We're gonna release him.
Any guesses on which person will run up first?
Ciao!
Boy, did he go.
Sorry, Brad.
Gotta love it, mate. It's back here. Gotta love it.
Yeah, thanks.
Well done, Greg. Good stuff, mate.
For filming, mate.
Hold on, mate. Good work.
Another dollar, mate.
Gentlemen, we expected an easier day today. What we didn't count on was having to dodge around elephant and buffalo and giraffe. 33-422, a new record.
There's the count. Tricking Illy's tricking brush.
Okay. Well done, Moose. We made it through another day.
Oh, thank you very much, Simon.
Lucky there's no smell-o-vision, that's all I can say.
Today, I think, has been our longest, eh?
It has. It's 12 hours.
It was longest in time, but it was about the same in terms of distance to yesterday. It was 23 years.
A couple of possible.
Just out this sixth row and just...
We have got a 4:30 wake-up call. It's 9:30 now, the latest we've been to sleep so far. Dumatau, here we come. Good night.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Ready to go, let's rock and roll. There'll be absolutely no smut today, gentlemen. Smut free.
Righto.
Nobody's cried yet, remember?
Let's get a bit of structure. We're in the opens. Let's go.
You really want for nothing today.
That's the Lunyanti fault line. The Lunyanti swamp is a delta as well. I'm going to be walking up this fault line towards Dumatau. There's a little channel over here called the Savuti Channel. I'm be walking around it into Dumatau camp. So that line you see in the distance there with the trees on it is actually this fault line. At some stage, many, many thousands of years ago, this whole piece of ground collapsed into the ground. And the rivers that used to flow through here were dammed up in a mini delta, and that's called the Lunyanti Swamp. Okavango is exactly the same thing, but many, many more times larger. Guys, we're going to be walking around this side of this bush. The big problem walking between the water and the bush, if there are any hippos in this bush over here which would want to return to the water, we'd be in their way. Now, these type of hippos would most probably be male hippos that have been pushed out of the water by dominant bulls and been injured, or hippos that have just had enough of getting back to the water, or those coming back late. Here we go, swamp to swamp. We eventually arrived at Lunyanti, eh?
Wow.
How many kilometers is that? Total so far? On foot?
106.
106 kilometers later, from the Okavango to the Lunyanti. So this is one of the toad species. If you look at these speckles, look at the red spots, we have the guttural toad and the olive toad in the area. These are these toxic secretions which the toads give off. We've seen a lot of this on the walk. This is the jasmine creeper. Now with the bushman, very popular. It's a bit of a rope. Without having to twine a bit of baobab bark, you've got a bit of rope to tie and some meat on your back to tie your supplies on. You can see you can knot it. It's one of the few plants that you can tie up without it breaking. And then this is the fruit over here. The bushman, very similar to the Aborigines of Australia. They know the bush. This is one of the edible fruits of the area. The outer covering is quite bitter, but the inside is quite tasty. And you look how much moisture is in this.
Tastes like chicken.
Tastes like
it's like a cucumber, actually.
In many parts of these explorations, nobody knew where it was. Now, you just look what we did this past week. Can you imagine trying to do that without a GPS? Trying to do that without all the supplies that we've had? It sounds almost impossible. Also with malaria, primitive drugs for malaria. I wouldn't even want to think of doing it. And he survived it. And that was just one of his explorations.
In all of Livingstone's wanderings, he converted only one chief. One. In all of his wanderings. So people sort of a bit cynical about whether he was a missionary. Explorer.
There was this huge rush to find a cure for malaria. Guys tried all forms of trees. They were taking roots, bulbs, etc. because they heard from a lot of local native tribes that there were herbs to cure malaria. And this one was called the fever berry. Now, all the documentation you read is contradictory. But some of it says that this was used by some of the native tribes to cure malaria. It doesn't work. If you look at this tree, it's been pushed over by an elephant. It's an African mangosteen. This is the fruit that you guys were tasting just now. It's the one I gave Steve. But it wasn't all that difficult for the elephant. If you look carefully, this tree's been colonized by termites. Half the bark has been destroyed, half the wood inside. And so the elephant detected there's a weakness. Also, if you look at the base here, what started this weakness, you see this hole? There's a perfect hole in there, and that is from the wood borer. Now, these are dead wood borers. I don't know why they're dead. But that's a wood boring beetle. This one's still alive. Rolling, 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 rolling.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. This is the Savuchi Channel. Beautiful, huh? We're about to cross this bend, pretty much on the home stretch into our destination, Dumatau, up further the Savuti River, which is called the Stolen River. With the shifting of the tectonic plates, it dried up some years back. But still lots of elephant in this area.
The best way to describe the rivers in northern Botswana, they're fickle. They cannot bust through because the gradient is just so low.
They spread out instead
of pushing.
Hasn't been up there for a long, long time.
Hearing hissing.
And then later there's a lot of Okavango specialists that get in the water, these animals. Okay. They just go scuba. Like a lot of like sharks and that, you don't get attacked under the water. When you're on the surface, you're vulnerable. But it's amazing how agile they are under the water. It's like trotting, walking, swimming.
Oh, Chunks, they're doing it up there. That's disco crunching.
How long can you do that for?
Oh, usually a minute.
Very impressive.
Well done.
Brad, how many are you with that?
It's a stunning forest of mangosteens. Lots of vitamin C in there. See, quite yummy, tangy, tart, delicious.
We've only been in Africa for 100 years, studying wildlife, and intensely studying wildlife for 30 years. We've got no idea of what's going on here. It looks like a lot of people would call this destruction. I don't think we have the right to call this destruction. This is a change in habitat. Sure, there are species being lost, and there are human issues involved, like hunting, wars, etc., etc. But right now, the largest land mammal, only 300 to 400 to 500,000 left in Africa. I don't think we have a right to start killing them off.
For us as guides here, I think we're working in one of the last few Edens of wildlife in southern Africa.
After 6 days of walking, it's about a kilometer away.
It's exceptional. Had a great time.
Camp company's been first class, and it's gone very quickly.
I've been to Africa, this is my fourth time, and I've never experienced it like this. It's just been amazing. I mean, physically challenging, emotionally uplifting, just the things we saw, the camaraderie amongst the group. We all got on incredibly well.
Learned a lot, probably didn't absorb as much as we were told, but nevertheless, an excellent safari.
Some very good memories. That's been a fantastic trip.
Not sorry.
It's been a long, hard road, Simon, but most rewarding.
Boys have done well, haven't they, mate?
The professionalism that's been showed by everyone, but particularly the shepherding of Aunt Tony, has been outstanding. And it's just it's a relief that everyone's got here, obviously, with all limbs working and safely. But it's a hell of an achievement. I think it's something that'll stay with people for the rest of their life.
But no one's grizzled, no one's groaned, no one's had any harsh words at any time. It's been brilliantly organised, and of course it goes without saying that Tony and Ant have just done an extraordinary job of just kind of nursing us through this. So glad and very privileged to have been a part of it.
We've still got this very thick bush on the right, which is keeping my mind busy. Quite emotional. Yeah, with all sincerity and extreme pleasure to take a bunch of Aussies as our first-time tourists with Brad over this incredible expanse of wild backcountry. Give him a bit of a...
It's been a pleasure to do it with such a happy, confident bunch of well-adjusted men.
Mate. Well adjusted, I'm not sure, yeah. But
mate, great, agree to with the rest of it. Great to meet you all. Yeah. Brad.
A namesake.
Thanks, mate. Yeah, thank you,
mate. It takes some courage to do this. You know, it's not for the faint of heart. And whilst we trivialise it in the true Australian way, you know, it is a dangerous undertaking. And we've been blessed to come through.
Well done, congratulations.
Thanks, all man.
You're welcome.
Thanks,
man.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks,
man. Foreman. Thanks, man. Foreman has come in, eh?
Well done. Si, we walked basically 122 Ks.
Yep.
I think we worked it out on about 96 straight line, Vumbra to Dumatal. The boys have done
meandering.
A bit of meandering, 122.
Last day today, a bit of a softer day, 19,270. It's a total over 6 days of about 180,000, averaged about 30,000 a day. About 125 kilometres, so big effort by all the boys.
The first two nights at Duba, you can see this little channel that was in front of the camp. That's where all that lovely line action. And then we flew over to the Vumbra airstrip, which is just over here. And that's where we started the walk, all the way through this thick, thick woodland, the Mapani. And slowly cutting up to Ketemetsi. Took us 2 days to get there. Our first overnight stop was there. And then from Ketemetsi, 20 kilometers, 20 kilometers, and then we followed our secret channel to Zivilianja camp.
And then Ziblianja camp, we spent the night over there, it was last night. This morning we walked around. See the fault line? There's the Savuti channel, we crossed the channel. We made our way slowly up, and that's where we are in our safari camp.
Sensible people like me sit around the bar and drink. Paul is doing the crossover crunches. Brad's just doing the straight old 1,000 push-ups after running about 500 miles.
They are completely mad, these two. Completely mad!
Lots of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees.
Now this is possibly why they're so relaxed. There's this excessive abundance of prey around. November, December, there are baby impala, there are baby all forms of things. And as you go towards January, February, March, you've got baby kudus, you have baby zebras. That's why they're just relaxing like this. Quite interesting, you have one looking that way and one looking this way. Their main enemy item is a lion. And secondly, a big male leopard. Look at that lovely battler. If you had to have a leopard coming over, a big male, he'll chase these cheetahs away, or there'll be a confrontation. But if lions had to catch a cheetah, they'll kill it. As close as what will stop focusing, which is about then. Look how you can go right into a piece of grass. That's macro, so you're going right in as opposed to zoom, which is far away. They make great photos. We're going to slowly move forward. I would say take a safety shot of that baboon in front there. Try them running, it makes a great shot. Doesn't matter how blurred it is, it's a great pick. Look how fast this little thing can run. Guys, that's a tough picture. Nice fringe lighting. Brad, he's just screaming out there. Should we take a cup? He's displaying. This is the woodland or the Angolan kingfisher. Okay, guys, there's your pick.
This is some very pretty stuff. Oh, look at that, you guys.
Oh,
it's a perfect reading shot.
Quite as good as that.
Show me that.
Look at this friggin' picture. Rolling. Look at this. I would say, guys, get your cameras ready. It's going to be another little scrap there. Look at the hole in the side, eh?
Yeah.
What I would say is happening is you've got a new male.
Well, we've had a fantastic morning game drive here at Dumatau. Bumping along the wetland area. Lots of bird sightings, beautiful bird sightings. And now just meters away from this big pot of hippo with a couple of guys, a couple of sort of teenagers having a bit of a scrap up here.
can't ask for anything more.
There's a red-shouldered widow bird.
I got three.
Okay.
I got three. I've just been using them. You just leave it on AWB.
Stop. Take photos.
Most beautiful bird in all of Africa, I reckon.
The malachite kingfisher, just amazing colours, beautiful little critter. And then something a lot of scientists talk about, look how colourful the bird is. Why would a bird want to be so colourful? Now, one of the most ludicrous theories, but the more I hear about it, the more it makes sense, is to attract flying insects. They think the bird is a flower. Look at this, it's a whole, there they go, going for a dip. Dip in the water, they've had a whole morning of feeding. Now just look at how many dragonflies around that they're feeding on. If mother is chewing up a bumblebee, the carmine beater and the little beater.
Watch this.
Lovely light.
Have a look at this. Almost perfect exposure. Mm-hmm. Got some great stuff there, Steve.
Oh, yeah.
You guys on the 350 and the 400Ds, you've also got a histogram. You see the light's more normal here. There's less varied light. It helps you get an idea of what your exposure's about. Qantas pilot and hairdresser. The prophet.
The old bullfighter's got a young body. Oh, that's nice. Try and get that. Try and get him with this, throwing dust on his face.
I didn't
see
any
cheek bone. You see this thing here?
Look at that. That's a nice shot.
Smelling.
Now I can sit and watch these guys all day.
Yeah, absolutely.
Here we go.
You're going to give us a little display at some stage. It's quite focused. Yeah. Head shake and sort of move on. Now I'll show you the head shake.
Which one? The little baby on the right-hand side of the bush. Take that photo.
Now, as Tony's been saying, we would never, ever have been able to get this close to a herd like this on foot. They would have been or felt very uncomfortable with our presence on foot. But in a vehicle, no problems at all. But you could see that guy at the end there just giving us a little display, just telling us he's bigger than we are and he can push us around if it came to that. Fantastic way to finish the day off.
I propose a toast to Gary and Paul for their patience with these budding sort of apprentice photographers.
You feel every movement of the bush, you're conscious of what's behind every tree, around every corner. Great to spend time with my kindy buddy, Simon. It's been a while, 40 years since we're at kindergarten. We've always had a common interest in this sort of stuff. And to finally get out here and go on foot really tops everything.
That's it, the end of an amazing safari. It'll be great to see our families again, that's for sure. I'm sure some of them figured we'd maybe never be coming back from this. Bye bye Africa, bye bye Botswana. Until next time.